Lydia, are you there? I just wanted to say congrats. I heard the news that you were finally going to be getting married. Dean told me all about it, actually.
Oh, well, thank you for those kind words, Hilda.
And I bet that you're just so relieved over all of this since you're turning 35 today, right? I mean, I bet your parents have got to be really happy too now that their daughter is finally getting married off.
Yeah, I mean, I suppose they are happy for me.
But you know, I heard something about that man you were going to marry. I heard that he didn't even graduate high school. Were your parents happy about that? Or were they just content that you could find someone to take you off the market? Because I can tell you that if it was me and my parents, oof.
Sorry, Hilda, I think that we might be having some kind of misunderstanding here. I mean, we're not that old, and it's not just that he didn't finish high school. In fact, I get the sense that you're just trying to put me down for my wedding.
What are you talking about? I'm not trying to make fun of you. I am making fun of you. But don't worry, I also have to say that I really respect you.
Oh, really? And just how do you respect me?
Well, I mean, to think that you're getting so old and still not married, and then you finally decided to settle down with some dropout flunky. I don't think that I could live a life like that. So I think it's great that you've chosen to. I just hope you're ready to be a wife to that kind of man. And anyways, I guess it's just all that resolution that you're saying that makes me admire you.
I don't think you said one word of admiration in any of those texts at all. I knew it. You were just making fun of me.
Oh, come on. I'm not making fun of you. That badly, right? Besides, I really do appreciate the dedication to still trying to get married this late in the game. I'm happy for you. After all, you didn't even graduate high school either, right? So I think it's just so great that a couple of lowlifes like you can find each other.
Okay, now this is just starting to get ridiculous. I really don't get why you feel the need to be saying any of this. But I don't appreciate you disparaging against my fiancé like this. And I don't think that our education levels are really any concern of yours. You know that schooling isn't everything, right?
Well, you say that, but of course it has a lot to do with how much you get paid for your job, doesn't it? After all, your brother Dean went to a great school and now he works at a job where he earns over $1 million a year. And as for me, I also went to an Ivy League school and I'm in line for a big promotion next quarter.
And I think those are both such impressive things to accomplish in your 20s. But I still don't think that that gives you the right to put others down like you have my fiancé and I. In fact, I really would like an apology from you for what you said.
What? You think that someone like me needs to apologize to someone like you? I think that you need to wake up and get a grip on reality. Why in the world should I have to lower myself to say sorry to someone like you? I think that you're being so selfish if you think I should actually have to do that. You choose to live the life that you did, so don't be mad at others for your choices.
Oh, come on. Do you really think that justifies the way that you've been acting?
Oh, well, I'm just so sorry if I hit a nerve with that. But the fact of the matter is, I'm doing things with my life that you couldn't dream of. In fact, I have to go and prepare for a very important business right now. So I'll talk to you later. And good luck working whatever minimum wage job you managed to get for yourself.
Hey, Lydia. You there? I just wanted to double check that it's okay if we don't go to your wedding. I mean, I just want you to know that I've been really looking forward to it, but...
Sorry, Dean. What are you talking about? Why wouldn't you come to our wedding?
Well, it's just that I get that you're wanting to cut back on costs for the event, but I didn't expect you to cut me out of the wedding. I was just kind of hoping that I could be there for you.
Wait just a second there. What are you talking about? And why do you think that you're not coming to my wedding?
Well, you are going to be getting married, right? Just heard from Hilda. About you were starting to get worried about the cross of the wedding, and so you're cutting down on some of the plans. Hilda told me that it would basically only be the parents that were showing up. That's what you told Hilda to tell me about the wedding, right?
What in the world? Are you serious? Did she really say all of that to you? Because I will have you know that I didn't say one word of any of that to her at all. This whole thing is just ridiculous.
So then, I can still go to your wedding?
Of course you can. The wedding plans are going to be the same as they've always been. You are going to be there, and so are the rest of our family and friends. Yes, I am trying to keep things cheap for myself, but I'm not going to cut down my wedding party that size.
Oh, so then we can really show up. You haven't actually cut out our place at the wedding.
Yes, of course you can still come. I would love for you to be there. You're my brother, for crying out loud. I actually can't believe that Hilda would say something like that to you. It sounds to me like she was trying to get out of having to come to my wedding at all, and that's why she lied to you.
Oh, you mean that you really think this was all some kind of plan by Hilda to not go to your wedding?
You know, just the other day, she was making fun of me for my lack of schooling and was talking about how much better she is than everyone. I bet she just didn't want to come to my wedding to spite me, and that's why she came up with such a ridiculous lie.
Oh, wow. I actually had no idea about any of this at all. I'm so sorry that he's tried to do this, Lydia. I've told her over and over again to try and get along with you and stop messing with you, but she just doesn't seem to get it.
I don't think it's something that you should be apologizing for, Dean. But Hilda just seems to really enjoy lording all the fancy schools that she got to go to over me. That it's obvious that she's looking down at me and my fiancé for not having gone to a nice school.
Well, I hope you really do know how sorry I am for her attitude. After all, the whole reason why you had to drop out of high school was for my sake.
What do you mean by that, Dean?
Well, it's the truth, isn't it? When I was little, I got really sick and we needed money to afford the treatment, especially since at the time it wasn't going to be covered by our insurance. We were going to have to pay for it all, and that's why you dropped out. You did it so that you could try and take care of me.
I don't want you feeling bad about anything that happened in the past concerning that, okay? The thing is that I didn't really want to finish high school then. I was ready to go out and join the workforce already. You didn't force me to do anything that I didn't already want to do, okay?
Well, you say that, but you're just trying to make me feel better.
Of course I'm not. But if you really want to pay me back for all those years, then you had better be there at my wedding, okay? It's going to be a big, important celebration to me that won't be complete if you aren't there for me, okay?
Got it. In that case, you can count on us being there. I wouldn't miss this for the world. The moment you have the date, let me know, and we'll be there.
Sorry. The thing is that Dean and I aren't going to make it to your wedding.
Wait, you two aren't going to be here?
Yeah, we changed our minds at the very last second. I didn't see any reason why we should be there. So, anyways, we're not going to be there for you on your big day. After all, why should we waste our precious time off going to see a couple of losers like you getting married? I would rather die than have someone see me there.
So you're saying that you don't want to be here that badly?
I don't think you understand. In this world, time is money. Dean and I's time is just worth more than even going to your wedding. Do you really think we can give our precious time just like that? If you wanted us for even half the day, you could buy our time for $10,000.
So, you just want me to pay you and my brother just to show up at my wedding?
That's right. So you had better pay up if you wanted us to be there. Although, I seriously doubt a couple of poor nobodies like you could afford us. So anyways, that's why we're not going to be able to go to your wedding. You just don't have that kind of money.
Hold it right there. I think I see what's going on here. You're basically saying that you don't think my wedding will be worth anything, do you?
Is it that obvious?
Well, I can't tell you what to do, and I won't force you to come to my wedding. But I wonder if you're speaking for both of you.
Oh, you mean you're wondering if Dean can go. I'm so sorry to say, but he doesn't even want to be there. He said so himself. So you can't afford me, and your brother doesn't even want to go.
And you're telling me that my brother really said that?
You mean that he didn't want to go? Of course he really said it. Why would anyone want to go to a wedding like yours anyways? If anyone valued their time, they would see that there was no value in going to yours.
You know, I think you're the only one that actually feels that way. and you've gone too far in trying to ruin my wedding.
Oh yeah? And what is a loser like you going to do? I bet nobody even showed up to your joke of a wedding.
The only one who isn't here is you, Hilda. My relatives, friends, everyone invited has shown up to this wedding. You're the only idiot who hasn't.
Hold on a second. Why are you talking to me like that?
It's me, Hilda. It's Dean. What is the matter with you? You couldn't even come up with a good excuse? You couldn't just say that you were sick or had a last-minute emergency? I'm just disappointed in you. Why are you being this cruel, Hilda?
Hold on a second. Why are you texting me from Hilda's number?
Well, maybe because I'm here for her wedding. She just showed me what you've been saying.
But you shouldn't be there. I changed the date on our invitation. You shouldn't have known when or where the wedding was.
Oh, I noticed that you did that long ago. So I asked Lydia myself about what day she was getting married.
So you know that I had changed the dates.
You know, for such a well-educated person, your handwriting sure is sloppy. Did you think that you had covered your tracks? A toddler could do that better than you. You really thought that you were going to keep me from being at my own sister's wedding.
Understand. So you know that I lied to you and you pretended like you didn't know? But then that means that you were lying to me.
Only because you started it. But you should know that it's not just Lydia's friends and family. It's also her staff who came to see their company president get married.
Wait, their company president? What is that supposed to mean?
Oh, didn't you know? My sister manages her own company. She's a CEO. So it's not just people you'd have known, but you know, it isn't just the board or the managers, it's all her staff.
Wait, that doesn't make any sense at all. I mean, I had no idea that Hilda ran her own company. This is the first time that I'm hearing about any of this. I mean, I thought that she never finished high school. I thought that she was marrying a flunky, but she's really leading a whole company?
The only thing that doesn't make sense around here is you. You're the one who tried to sabotage me going to Lydia's wedding. You're just awful. You think you're better than everyone, but you're not. And yeah, if you must know, the two of them didn't finish high school. But the reason for them both was that they had family circumstances that forced them to drop out. But the truth is that they did what they did in order to take care of their family. In fact, when Lydia's husband dropped out, he was really into film. He started a production company that he runs as well.
You're kidding me, but that's... Oh, I had no idea.
I know, right? Still a teenager and he went off to start his own film business. Do you think you could ever do anything like that? You kept making fun of them because they had dropped out, but you never even bothered to see what they had done since then. They're much bigger than you could ever hope to be.
Wait, hold on, why are you so upset with me? Dean, I haven't seen this side of you.
You know why I respect my sister? Because she gave up everything to take care of me. She did that and still managed to make something amazing with her life. Not only that, but she never ever held what she did for me against me. She did all of that for me and you put her down for it. You let your horrible biases and assumptions get in the way of even trying to get to know her. I can't be with you anymore. We are going to get a divorce when we get back home, Lydia. I can't do this anymore.
Wait, Dean, no! You can't be serious, please. This can't be happening to me. I don't want to get a divorce from you.
No, I've had enough of this. You and I are going to have a long, long talk when we get back home. Now, if you'll excuse me, we have a wedding to celebrate here. I'll see you at home, Hilda.
Please let me in. I'm here to celebrate your wedding, Lydia. You have to let me in.
Wait, what? You want to come and help celebrate my wedding? But I thought you said that it wasn't worth coming for anymore.
I know. I said a lot of things, but I didn't mean it. I'm so, so sorry for everything that I said. You have to let me in. Can you go and tell your brother that I'm here? You have to tell him to help me get in. Please, you have to tell him to stay with me.
That's not going to happen. Do you understand? So why don't you just come home and leave us alone already?
What? No, please, you can't do this to me. I came all this way. You have to let me in.
You think I'm going to let you come in here after all that you've put me through? You've got some nerve, do you know that? You've done nothing but insult me and put me down, and you haven't given one real apology yet.
Please? I didn't do anything wrong. You have to know that I wasn't trying to hurt your feelings or anything like that. I really did come here to help you celebrate. You have to let me into here. You don't understand. I've graduated from one of the top schools in the country. You just can't keep me out of here.
I'm sorry, but no fancy college pedigree is going to save you here.
But please, I really am sorry. Can't you just let me in? I am not going to go home until you let me in.
Okay, so stand out there and cry for all I care. I won't be opening the door and letting you in.
If you don't let me in, then I'll have to break my way in. I won't let you keep me apart from my husband. I am just going to get him back and fix this.
Hold on a second. I would try and think hard about where you are right now.
What do you mean? I'm at some loser idiot's wedding. You think I care about barging in there? I'll knock this door down right now.
Hold on a second. What I'm trying to say is that I think you're at the wrong place. I don't actually think you're here.
What do you mean? Where am I then?
Well, we had closed the doors and we thought that you were going to be coming. But then we realized we couldn't hear any banging or crying or shouting or anything. I think you might have gone to the fake place that you wrote on the invitation.
But I just broke the door down. Are you telling me that I actually went to the wrong wedding? This isn't yours? Okay, well, I think that I gotta run right now. But we're not through here. We have plenty more to talk about.
Hilda, I think that you should just give yourself up and come home. Don't get into any more trouble.
No, I can't get caught. I'm not going to be forced to apologize for something so humiliating.
I think that you're only going to make things worse for yourself.
I'm not going to let you fool me into embarrassing myself like that. I'm not that stupid.
Okay, you know what? I tried. But you do whatever you want. I don't know why I'm even wasting my time texting you on my wedding!
But wait, so then you're just going to leave me like this? You can't do that! Please, you have to help me out here. Hello? Lydia? Are you there?
The other wedding that Hilda went to. My caterer was happy to fill me in on what happened next. Hilda ran to the bathroom to think of what to do next and was quickly cornered. In the end, she was forced to apologize for interrupting the wedding. She was also stuck with a fee of thousands of dollars, and to top it all off, Dean divorced her as well. When her parents found out why she was getting divorced, they got so mad at her. They told her that if she was so clever, then she should figure out a way to pay back all the tuition they had shelled out for her. Last I heard, Hilda's having to pay back as much as $1 million for all her mistakes. As for me, I was able to safely return to my wedding. I can safely say that for the rest of it, I did not think of Hilda or any of her schemes, even once. I was too busy enjoying my time, surrounded by loved ones. I'm honestly amazed that Hilda had no idea who I was. She would go on all the time about how many people she knew and what celebrities she was friends with. Later, her parents came to visit me and apologized directly to me. They told me that their daughter had wanted to go to an Ivy League school so badly that they had masterminded bribes to her high school and the university just to get her considered. It turns out that she never belonged there in the first place. I'd hoped that we could get along, if nothing for my brother's sake. I did my best to make things work, but it was no good. But now, I'm just glad to be rid of her.
Danny, please stop ignoring me. If you're mad, please talk to me about it. I can't apologize if you don't.
You're such a useless wife. You still don't understand why your husband is upset with you.
You finally responded. So you really are mad over something I did?
Anytime I'm mad, it's because of you. Last night you gave me the same side dish as the day before, didn't you?
Oh, you mean the roasted Brussels sprouts? I figured I should start making side dishes that can be prepared quickly. If I can make them all in one day, I can prepare dinner a lot faster.
That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard. Pre-made dishes. You're just trying to find ways to slack off. I'm not gonna have any housewife of mine slack off.
What?
Your husband should be served dishes freshly made. That's what's expected around here. Serving the same dish twice in a row, and then also being pre-made is just insulting. Are you that dumb to not know something this obvious?
I'm not slacking off. I just figured that making them all at once would be saving time and energy. Besides, there are some meals that taste better after a few days of marinating.
Shut up. It's all because of me that you're able to live the life you currently have. Who do you think you are to argue with me?
You always say this.
Listen closely. Never do something like this again. Next time this happens, I won't just ignore you. I'll kick you out. Wives are meant to take care of their husband's needs. What in the world is this lunch? This has the side dishes that we had last night. Did you already forget what I told you last month?
I'm sorry, Danny, but I haven't been feeling good since last night. I just couldn't make any dishes for you this morning.
You're sick. All you do is stay home all day.
Well, you see, it's because I'm pregnant.
Wait, really?
I really didn't feel good, so I went to the hospital today and they told me I was pregnant. They said the sickness is due to that.
Really? I finally get to be a father. Great job, Amy.
I'm glad you're so excited, but could I ask that you help around the house now? I need you to forgive me as I gradually become unable to move around much.
What did you say?
I can't explain how much the morning sickness is affecting me. With how things are going to be in the future, I think it's best you learn how to do these chores. I'll be really busy with looking after our kid once they're born. It would really help that you could at least take care of yourself.
Don't be stupid. Raising a child and housework is both your responsibility as a mother. Don't be pushing all kinds of work onto me just because you're pregnant.
What?
Those are all duties that are expected of a housewife. I'm not doing a single bit of housework, not now, not ever.
Come on.
You may have some sickness going on, but keep working. I'm not helping in the slightest, but I expect you to give me a cute baby. Oh, by the way, this weekend I'll be out on a trip with some friends.
Wait a minute. Could you cancel those plans? I want you to come with me to the hospital.
Why in the world would I need to go there with you?
The doctor said that the next examination should be with you there as well. So could you please go with me?
There is nothing I can do there. Just say I have work or something.
This is about our child, though. Your plans with friends are more important than that?
Of course they are. I've only known you for 6 years. Compared to the 20 years I've known my friends, that's practically nothing. So don't get in my way.
But, please!
Anyways, I'm going back to work now. I'll forgive this lunch incident because of the pregnancy announcement, but don't think I'll be as forgiving for dinner.
I heard the news. Congrats, Amy. Oh, wow. He told you already? Yeah. He apologized for introducing me to my grandchild. I told him that there's no need to apologize. Such a serious boy. I can't believe this. We still don't know the safeness of this pregnancy yet. He just started announcing it without my permission. What? You still don't know yet. Since he contacted me, I thought it was already stable. I only found out I was pregnant yesterday. I'm still only 4 weeks along. Wait, really? He's so clueless, I swear. I'm sorry, honey. I bet you didn't want others to know just yet. I'm sorry as well. You did nothing wrong, and I'm here complaining to you. No, dear. You have every right to be mad. I'll be sure to tell my son that. I'm sorry that he's so clueless. Kathy, I don't think I can stand this anymore. Will you forgive me if I divorce your son? Divorce? What happened? Is his cluelessness really that bad? I'm sorry. That must be my fault. Please, could you reconsider? You did nothing wrong, Kathy. I just can't handle anymore. He is so cold towards me, and now his own child as well. I can't stand to be with someone this unforgiving as him. What? I've always known that he's a bit old-fashioned with his ideals of marriage, but it's gotten worse. He's so strict on everything, including housework, and if I try to explain that housework is still hard, he gets mad. I was told to be a proper housewife and mother without his help. You're kidding! He's been saying all these horrible things to you? He rejected my request in going to the hospital with me this weekend because hanging out with his friends is way more important. I can't be with this kind of person any longer. How horrible! You know what? I'll go with you this weekend in place of him. I'll drive you there and wait for you in the car the entire time. You do that for me? Of course. But first, I need you to calm down. You have to think about your child and maybe think about the divorce just a bit more. If you still want to get a divorce after that, then rest assured, we will be on your side. Thank you so much. I think I can finally calm down a bit. That's good. I'll see you next week for the appointment. And if you're feeling okay, then maybe we can have some lunch or coffee afterwards.
Hey, are you at my parents' house already?
Yes, I just arrived. Kathy went out of her way to pick me up.
Listen up. This visit is all thanks to my wonderful parents, since your parents are not around anymore. My parents are the one who gave us the okay to visit. You better be grateful for their kindness.
Of course I'm grateful. They saw how much pain I'm in and offered us to go visit them. There is no way I wouldn't be thankful of your parents. I have none of those thoughts towards you, though.
What do you mean you're not grateful for me? A wife should always be grateful of their husband.
I'm not seeing the problem here, as I'm not gonna be your wife for much longer.
What?
I was scared of telling you in person, but I'll say it now. I want a divorce.
Huh? Where is this coming from?
I can't stand you for much longer. I refuse to raise a child with you.
That's ridiculous. How dare you talk, Almighty, when you've been living off of my money? And when you're visiting my parents, who are you to request a divorce?
It doesn't matter what you think because I'm serious. I've been thinking about this for a while now.
You were thinking about it that much? How is it that you've been thinking about it but are too stupid to realize where you stand? You'd be homeless if you divorced me.
Speak of homes, our house is about to be deconstructed.
What?
Either way, if I divorce you, we're both gonna be homeless. So that threat means absolutely nothing.
What do you mean deconstructed? What are you talking about?
I think it was an hour after you saw off to work this morning, when the demolition workers came in. To which, after talking with them, I contacted your parents. The demolists have been sending me pictures of their progress, and have to admit, they're doing a great job. They'll be done by later today.
Hang on. What is going on? What are you doing letting our house get destroyed? Don't tell me that you're going to use the money from the deconstruction to pay for our child's care.
Bingo. You got it in one. The owner of the house was set as your mother, which he gave to me.
What?
I didn't know that the house that we're living in was in the possession of your mother the entire time. What was even more surprising is that you have been living here rent-free. You told me that the rent was $1,000 a month, so that you can only give me $500 a month.
I mean, I can explain.
I'm sure you have much to say, but I'm gonna divorce you either way, so you can save it. Just be sure to sign the document soon. I've already signed my name on it. Your mother will be bringing you the documents to your job later.
Hang on a minute. I don't understand how this is happening. The rent being zero coming to light, my mother approving of destroying the house.
I'm not asking for your understanding. Never mind all that. Just promise you'll sign the divorce papers. I can't stand living with you any longer.
No way. There is no way I'll sign those stupid papers. I don't know what or how you have my parents' support, but I won't forgive this.
That's my line. To have your amazing wife request a divorce, you aren't fit for being a husband or father. Shut up and sign the papers. Your father and I are on Amy's side on this.
What? Mom?
You are so stupid. Treating someone who tries their hardest with you with such disrespect. Not only that, but stating that you won't be helping in raising your child? I've heard everything from Amy already.
What? She ratted me out?
Where did I go wrong? I honestly feel sorry for you. I can't even fathom how Amy's late parents feel about all this. A man who can help his wife should hurry up and sign the divorce papers.
What? Come on, Mom. Why are you protecting her so much?
Huh?
You should be helping out your son with convincing her to reconsider divorcing me. I know I've been acting high and mighty, but I'll be better from now on. So please reconsider. I need your help too, Mom.
This is beyond convincing her to reconsider. Why don't you understand that?
What?
But fine. I'll give you a chance. You did say you'll behave better. I'm gonna evaluate you to see if you're worth Amy reconsidering.
What kind of evaluation? You gonna grade an apology letter or something?
Just answer the questions I ask. Think about the money I gave you in aid of the birth of your child.
The what?
I gave you the money when you told me the news, didn't I? To use it to aid you guys with your baby. Your father and I gave you $5,000. If you weren't a rotten man, you would have used the money properly, right?
Well, you see...
A rotten man is all words. If you claim to fix your attitude, I would need to make sure of that. So, what did you do with it? What did you use the money I sent you on? Did you even give it to Amy? If you want my help, you better answer.
I'm sorry. I used all the money hanging out with my friends. I paid the gasoline, did some gambling, and bought fishing equipment. I was only planning on using a small portion of it, but it all ended up being used hanging out with them.
I can't believe you! To think that my own son would become this rotten! As you can already guess, you failed. We will be celebrating your divorce.
What?
We will be watching Amy at our house. As long as she is at our house, you better not show your face here. Your father and I will be protecting her and the child in her belly.
Wait, Mom, please give me time to talk to Amy alone.
You don't even deserve that luxury. Your father will be over soon to hand you the divorce papers. I expect you to sign it. If you don't, we will be informing all your colleagues about this.
Come on, Amy. I had no choice to sign the papers. My dad really did come to my job. I only signed it because I was threatened. I don't want to get a divorce.
I don't care. I wanted a divorce. The papers have been safely handed over. Thanks for your cooperation.
You already handed the papers in?
It's best to turn these things as soon as possible.
Please, Amy, don't do this to me. I was looking forward to meeting my child. I'll be better. So please, let's be a family again.
Absolutely not. I just learned about the money your parents gave you. Just thinking about it gets me so mad.
I'll pay it back. You can take it out of my savings.
You owe me way more than that now. I expect money as a consolation for future property, as well as childcare once I give birth.
All of that?
These are the expected things you're supposed to pay.
What's wrong with you? I'm here begging for you, and you show me this kind of attitude? I've lost not only my home, but also the support of my parents because of you. Don't you feel guilty for all this?
Not at all.
Huh?
Oh, that's right. The demolition crew contacted me again. They are almost done with, and will definitely be done by tomorrow.
What? They're almost done? All those memories we created at that house. All your belongings are off to the side. Make sure you pick those up. If not, then it'll all be gone along with the house tomorrow.
Well, I'm gonna head out then. I'll let you know more of the details of the money that you owe me soon. If you try to run away, you will not be permitted to see your child and expect to lose all ties cut with your family.
You're joking. That means I'll have to figure something out by today. Do you know if rental truck services will be of any use?
After a few months, I have safely given birth. I can't explain how thankful I am of Kathy and her husband's support. They even went as far as to offer to talk to Danny about the money he owes me, and they managed to get me the better end of a deal. I really can't express how they have helped me out. Even now, they visit the house that I moved out to with my child. They are really wonderful people. On a different note, my ex-husband managed to create a family and make new friends, and gradually became a better person for his other child. Once he lost everything and hit rock bottom, he started to get his act together.